that before it or after it. And I urge you and ask you to stay behind to hear the sermon and the speeches of our guests. In the first rak'ah, we will make 7 takbirah. Then I will recite al-Fatiha and 1 surah. In the second rak'ah, I will make 5 takbirah and then al-Fatiha and surah. After the prayers, we will have the sermon. Please straighten your lines and be prepared for the prayer.
Jazakumullah.
من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. أوصيكم عباد الله وإياي بتقوى الله وأحثكم على طاعته وأنهاكم عن مخالفته وأستسمح بالذي هو خير وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Dear brothers and sisters, we start this day after 30 days of fasting by making an additional prayer, a gesture of thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who enabled us to fast the 30 days of Ramadan and to reap the rewards of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our fasting and our hunger. What we have accomplished, what we have achieved after 30 days of hunger and thirst, this is what we are doing.
Say,
my prayer, my worship, my life and death are for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the essence of Islam. وَبِذَٰلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. I have been commanded to this and I am the first to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second achievement, by abstaining from food and drink and certain pleasures, we have achieved self-control over our wills and wishes. We can tell the shaitan that we are in control, not you. We are now able to endure difficulties and surmount obstacles that we are facing in our life. If I can do without for so many hours, if I can do without drink for so many hours, I can do without many things for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for attaining my goal. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us as He told us in the Quran. In this month, we have fasted in a perfect way, inshallah. We stopped eating at dawn, no less, no more. And we break our fast at the Maghrib time, no more and no less. And this is an indication how precise, how perfect we should be in our life as much as we can. And we carry this spirit beyond the month of Ramadan, into our own life, into our world, into our social relationships. We should seek perfection as we have been trained in us. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was always observing us. فَإِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى. He knows our secrets and what is even beyond the secret. And beyond the month of Ramadan, we should have this in mind. We should have that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our witness. He knows what we are doing. He knows our intentions. And we should move ahead with this in mind, to be better citizens, to be better in every aspect of our life, because He is supervising us. He is recording what we are doing. Not someone else, but Allah selected to be hungry and thirsty. But in our hunger and thirst, we remember the less fortunate, those who do not have a choice but to be hungry, those who do not have a choice but to drink from tainted water, and most of them, unfortunately, all over the world are Muslims. If you look at the Muslim world from Malaysia to Morocco, you will see many wounds and many Muslims who are hungry, not by choice. They are not hungry for 1 month. They are hungry for the whole year. They are drinking from muddy water, from rain water, from whatever they can, not by choice, because they have no other source. With our prayer, with our support, and we remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that on the day of judgment, to surmount the most difficulty, what you need to do. فَلَحْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةَ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ الْعَقَبَةَ فَكُّ رَقَبَةَ أَوْ إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ ذِي مَسْغَبَةٍ يَتِيمًا ذَا مَقْرَبَةٍ أَوْ مِسْكِينًا ذَا مَتْرَبَةٍ. This is the way to surmount the most important difficulty in your life on the day of judgment. To feed, to look after the orphan, to feed the needy and the poor. We have enjoyed the food and drink in this blessed country, but many other people do not enjoy it. And we have learned the value of the food that we have on our table. We have learned the value of the pure water that we drink. And based on that, we have remembered that these are precious fortunes, not only for us, not only for the Muslims, but for the prayer, the purpose of zakat, all is to lead you to the righteous behavior, to be observant always of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the lessons of the month of Ramadan. And let every one of us reflect, did we understand these lessons? Are we going to apply it not only for the month of Ramadan, but for the whole year? For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who decreed the fasting in this month, is the Lord of this month and the Lord of every month of the year. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us in this way. When we have a large gathering like this, it's very appropriate to reflect upon some of the challenges that we are facing as Muslims in Canada, as Canadians. The first challenge that we are facing is our youth. We, as Muslims, every Muslim family is at least has doubled the average Canadian number of children. And this is a great opportunity and a great challenge at the same time. They will have our children, all the future, to a great extent for us. And we need to educate them, not only in education, not only to have them as doctors and engineers and accountants and professionals, but to have them as good Muslims, as ambassadors of Islam in this country. We need to absorb their energy and channel it, so they will be, in the future, the leaders of Islam, the leaders of a moderate, balanced Islam that will indeed propagate the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a bright future for our country. The second challenge is our participation in decision making. As a new community, relatively new community, we are still at the receiving end of laws and decision making. Our participation is not as it should be. And as the new second and third generation of Muslims go into the working place, we hope that they will have a great role in decision making. And we call upon our politicians and government at every level to help in this, to help and to the participation of Muslim youth and to speed the process of Muslim integration into the Canadian society, to meet these challenges. However, there are two external challenges that we need to reflect. depicted as the danger within. We are being depicted as some people to be feared, and this way we are demonized. So our rights will be taken away from us, and no one will protest. So we need to reflect upon this, and we need to dispel this stereotype. We need to reach out to our neighbors, friends, colleagues, and we need our politicians to take a leadership role in this, to defend our rights, not to revoke our rights. We need our politicians to stand up for every citizen of Canada, including Muslims. Not to dance to the tune of some fear-monger when it is related to Muslims and Islam. And the second challenge that we have is Canada foreign policy. We are not succeeding as Muslims, and the politicians are not hearing us. They are not hearing the Canadian people even about foreign policy. Canada foreign policy in Afghanistan and regarding Gaza Strip is useless, unfortunately. The policy of starving the people of Gaza, of having a siege to the 1.5 million, is a complete failure. Relief organizations issued a statement condemning the siege. You cannot starve people because of their government, but this is a fact. This siege is killing many people. It reminds us as Muslims of the siege of Iraq, and it reminds us that some politicians at one time said it's worth it. Let the children of Iraq die. And now we are seeing the children of Gaza die. Our policies in Afghanistan is also doomed to fail. And this is something the Canadian people have said from day one. And the majority of them want us out of Afghanistan. And it took an election for our government to do this. And we are very sad for all the people who died for this cause in vain, unfortunately. There will be no peace in Afghanistan unless a political solution is found. And Switzerland has been in Afghanistan for many years. They issued a study saying that the West's effort is doomed to fail. We are perceived as occupiers. We have provided political stability, and it is the time to look for alternative solutions. As the Muslims of Canada, we would have hope that our government would consult Muslim organizations, that our government, whether this one or the previous one, or the future one, would take a leadership role in finding a proper solution for the problem of Afghanistan. But we have seen nothing. There is no leadership, unfortunately, in this regard. We are following others instead of taking the lead. We were able to succeed in the month of Ramadan, that we as Muslims and the whole country will succeed in meeting these challenges. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us in this way. Allah اجمعنا على ما يرضيك واحفظ بيننا وبين معاصيك واجعلنا من المتحافين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم من اراد بالاسلام والمسلمين خيرا فاخذه بكل خير. ومن اراد بالاسلام والمسلمين شرا فخذه اخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا الا غفرته. ولا هما الا فرجته. ولا دينا الا قضيته. ولا ذنبا الا غفرته. ولا مريضا الا شفيته. اللهم اشف مرضانا. اللهم عاف مبتلانا. اللهم ارحم موتانا. اللهم اجعل الجنه مثواهم ومثوانا يا ارحم الراحمين. الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر. وكل عام وانتم بخير. عيد مبارك. May he have a return to the world. والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله.
Father.